What is up, weather enthusiasts? I'm your host, Pat's Path Predictor. Let's get right into the weather. All right, so here's the situation we have for you, ladies and gentlemen. We have chances increasing for tropical development by the day. We have more models that are coming in there, continuing to double down on potentially very strong tropical development for November out of all months. And it continues to be a scenario where all five of the major models that we have used here on the Pat's Path Predictor channel, as well as the ensembles, are screaming, hey, something's about to happen. Hey, the conditions are going to be just right for this. Hey, something may be developing. What's going to be going on? We're going to go ahead and dive right into this. Here's the situation we have right now. Chances have increased for formation. Yesterday, they were at 20%. Roughly 12 hours ago, they were at 20%. Now, they're at 30%, and they are expected to continue to increase as the weekend continues to progress. Here's the situation. A broad area of low pressure is forecasted to form over the southwestern Caribbean Sea by the middle part of next week. Thereafter, environmental conditions appear conducive for gradual development of the system while it drifts slowly, remaining in the Caribbean Sea through the latter part of next week. Formation chance in the next 48 hours is still 0%. They do not have an idea of where the low pressure system is right now. Odds are it's likely part of the Central American gyre that is currently, if you take a look at satellite, currently impacting areas in Honduras, Nicaragua, Costa Rica, that area right there, that area of convection really starting to fire up as time continues to go on. And that's basically what I'm thinking is it's going to basically come off as and then just get over here. And we have a 30% chance of formation in the next 7 days, which has increased from 20%. So this isn't like a one-time thing where this is like it's a 20%. Just disregard this. No, the two things I'm noting right here are, number one, basically how far out the NHC is anticipating development. And two, the chances are increasing based on how far out that is. The first part of this is that this isn't expected to really start to organize and develop until, I'd say, Wednesday or Thursday, according to some of the models. That's the first thing I'm noticing. And the second thing I should emphasize is the NHC seems to be quite confident that something is going to be happening, because we're like, 5 to 6 days out before tropical development? And if they're calling for a potential tropical development from the gyre this early out, something may be going on, and something may be happening, and the NHC is very early catching this. So that's what we have going on right now with the National Hurricane Center forecast right now. We're going to go ahead and show you some of the models that we were talking about. Here's the European, then we're going to show you the GFS, the CMC, the ICON, and the NavGem. Here's the European showing signs of organization and development starting about 4 to 5 days out, according to the latest run. Heck, some model runs are indicating this may happen even later than expected, which, if that was the case, then that's even more scary, primarily because the energy is already tagging this as an area of interest. But anyway, about 6 days out, the European is showing signs of organization and development. While the European isn't exactly sure on how strong this is at this current point in time, I know the ensembles are screaming at something big potentially happening, and we'll get to those in a second, but I want to kind of show you the operational models, because the European does have something potentially developing at this current point in time, and the NHC is even showing something potentially developing at this current point in time. Next model run, we're going to go ahead and show you is the GFS. The GFS run is continuing to show signs of organization and development starting about 5 days from now, just off the coast of Nicaragua, before approaching Jamaica as a strong tropical storm or hurricane at this current point. However, as it approaches Jamaica, it continues to intensify at a very, very fast rate. And as time continues to go on, it makes landfall on Jamaica as a 974 millibar hurricane. That's equivalent to about Category 2 strength if you take into account pressure, winds, all that stuff. That's the typical wind to pressure ratio when it comes to these hurricanes. And then moves basically between Cuba and Haiti, making landfall in eastern Cuba right here, and while bringing lots of heavy rainfall and lots of very strong winds to Haiti, which is a country that absolutely does not need any kinds of impacts from this, primarily because there's an anarchy, they have the worst infrastructure, they're the poorest nation in the Western Hemisphere after Venezuela. it's an absolute mess. And then this hurricane moves through the Turks and Caicos and then kind of goes out to sea. But the GFS is interesting, and it's kind of like taking a U-turn and moving towards the Bahamas before dissipating. I don't trust that, let's be honest here. Anything out further than 10 days out when it comes to the GFS, take it with a massive grain of salt, or better yet, disregard it altogether. However, everything about 7 days out, definitely pay attention to it, because that is a very real possibility of that happening. And as soon as this gets designated as an invest, we'll be able to get some model runs and some scenarios of, at least with the hurricane models, to get some more data to compile all of that. So that's what we have going on with the GFS. Next model run we're showing you is the CMC. The CMC has been a very consistent model run when it comes to tropical development, and it's been kind of matching, being the middleman between the European and the GFS. The CMC, starting about 7 days out, is showing signs of organization and development as time continues to go on. If we go ahead and show you the if we go ahead and show you the 12Z right here, it's still showing that tropical development. There is disagreement on how fast it'll end up organizing and developing, and how fast it'll move. Like, at least the track will go at this current point in time. But the CMC is showing that organization and development. About 1,001 millibar system approaching Jamaica before strengthening as it approaches Cuba and Haiti over here by about 8 to 9 days out. So this is definitely something we need to pay attention to as time continues to go on, because all of these models are very consistent. And yesterday and still today, we have 5 out of 5 models calling for tropical development in the month of November, which that is even an even higher bar to raise right there. That's the CMC model. Next thing we're showing you is the NavGem, and the NavGem has been a pretty interesting model, to say at the very least. NavGem is showing signs of organization and development about 5 days out, a lot like the European and GFS and the rest of the models are. And then it approaches Jamaica as a 997 millibar strong tropical storm potentially has a chance to get up to weak hurricane strength before it makes landfall in Jamaica. And keep in mind, though, this is about 180 hours out. So if I were you, I would still pay attention to this. But for now, just understand that it is a bit a ways out before tropical development. But based on the fact that all the models are calling for it, and based on the fact that even the NHC is tagging an area of interest, it's definitely something we need to take a look at. Now we're going to go ahead and show you the last model, which is the Icon model. Icon has been one of those models that have been pretty interesting. If we show you the 0Z, we start seeing signs of organization and development before slowly moving off the coast of Honduras and Nicaragua and approaching Jamaica as a 997 millibar tropical system as of right there, similar to the NavGem, actually, as a matter of fact, bringing potentially very heavy rainfall and very strong wind as it makes landfall on Jamaica right there. So this is all stuff we need to pay attention to as time continues to go on. And over the weekend will absolutely be key, because as those chances continue to increase and as those chances continue to really show signs of organization and development right there, well, folks, well, it's gonna be a wild ride, especially for November, as it's right now November 10th. So by the time this thing potentially does organize and develop, it'll be around November 14th, November 15th, or something along those lines right there. So it's definitely something we need to keep an eye on. Now we're going to go ahead and show you the conditions that we're looking at. Here's the conditions. We have global sea temperatures exceeding 30 degrees Celsius all the way from tropical initiation to Jamaica, to Cuba, to Haiti, all that area right there, where there is a huge area of development, primarily due to those insanely warm waters that are 86 degrees Fahrenheit plus, for those of you who live in the United States and Puerto Rico. And another concern that I've been raising is that, let's say over the winter, if something doesn't develop, these waters start cooling off, and they don't cool off as much as they usually do, because we have a huge area of 28 plus degrees Celsius in the main development region, huge area of 28 plus degrees Celsius across the Atlantic Basin and Caribbean Sea. My concern is that those remain the same, at least from the Yucatan Peninsula, from south from Hispaniola and those areas right there. And then over the spring, when it starts to warm up again, well, that with a changing El Nino to La Nina pattern, or even neutral pattern, would really decrease the wind shear, decrease of all the limiting factors of tropical development and really ramp those up. And my concern is for 2024, we see even more dangerous storms than we did this year, because this year we saw 20 named or 21 named storms. This could be 22 if this does initiate right here. And 2024 is going to be a wild ride for hurricane season if that continues. That's the global sea temperatures. Another concern is the ocean heat content. Excuse me. The ocean heat content, well over to 150, pretty much from just south of Jamaica all the way to Cuba, Haiti, right there. And where this thing is expected to initiate, it's about, like, what? 100, 125 OHC. So we have more than enough fuel. The water is more than enough deep to support tropical development. If we take a look at the wind shear isn't that particularly favorable right now. But right now is right now, and we have 5 days before tropical development is anticipated. And in those 5 days, the wind shear is expected to decrease at a very fast rate. If we go ahead and show you the European shear forecast, as well as the moisture component to all this, we can kind of give you an understanding. Here's the wind shear forecast as of the 12Z of today. The shear forecast in the next 24 hours weakens down from like 30 to 40 knots down to about 20. And then starting by about 3 days out, it weakens even further right here. And we get a very favorable environment pretty much from Cuba to Panama all the way to Haiti right here. That little triangle of development right there, as I like to call it. The shear does come back for a little while, but then it starts to kind of regress as we start seeing a break in the shear, and then we start seeing a low pressure system kind of mess with the shear, especially as this thing really starts to get going right there. And the GFS is even more aggressive when it comes to the wind shear, showing not that much really going on at all as of right there, starting about 5 days out, showing even less wind shear. And a lot of the wind shear that's present is from the storm motion, and the shear that's up here may help actually enhance the outflow and help this thing develop even faster. That's what the GFS is initially anticipating for. So this is definitely all stuff we need to pay attention to, because the shear is absolutely forecasted to weaken. If we go ahead and show you the dry air, there's not really that much dry air to speak of at this current point in time. There is a bit of dry air that may be starting to intrude in the eastern part of the Caribbean, at least about 4 days out, but it's going to be held off by this moist stuff right here. And the Gulf of Mexico may see some dry air, but from what I'm seeing, especially 4 days out, we're starting to see that tropical initiation from the European, and there is plenty of moist air to do that. So this is all stuff we need to continue to pay attention to here on the Pat's Path Predictor channel, and we will keep you updated as more information continues to come out. But with that being said, we're going to go ahead and close the video out right here. I really hope you enjoyed it. Be sure to leave a like, subscribe to the channel if you are new. It helps us out, helps us make more videos like these. The goal of this channel is to get more people engaged with weather. And with that being said, have a wonderful day, guys. Stay safe.